What's good, guys? It's Zen, and today we are finally here in Season 23 to bring you the strongest solar builds. Today we're starting with Hunter, but be on the lookout for Warlock and Titan videos soon. With today's build, we will have infinite at-will ignitions, infinite restoration, and a one-shot super that we will be spamming. This build is extremely potent in Season 23 due to its usage of the new Solar Artifact perks, so let's waste no time and get right into it. Now guys, the first thing I want to break down is how we have infinite at-will ignitions. First of all, ignitions are these high damage explosions. Typically, the only way to get an ignition is to apply 100 stacks of Scorch, which is a damage over time burn effect. Applying 100 Scorch isn't always easy though. Thankfully, hunters have 3 ways to create ignitions on command without the need to get 100 Scorch stacks. Now the first way we can create our ignitions is with our weighted throwing knife. When you throw this knife at a scorched enemy, it ignites instantly. Now we can scorch enemies with our solar grenades, but the best way to apply scorch this season is with these two artifact perks. Flint Striker will give you radiant, which is a 25% universal weapon damage bonus for landing rapid solar weapon precision hits. Now while you're radiant, your solar weapons will apply scorch to targets thanks to Kindling trigger. It is very easy to maintain radiant and scorch rounds while using these artifact perks, so I heavily recommend using them in order to proc scorch for your throwing knives. Now in order to be able to spam your knife ignitions, you'll want to make sure to have on Gambler's Dodge, which refunds your melee charge after dodging near enemies. Our second and most lethal method of ignitions is our solar aspect, Gunpowder Gamble. Gunpowder Gamble gives you a meter with 5 charges on the left side of your screen. After you get 5 charges, you will gain access to a special ignition grenade that does heavier damage in a larger radius than a standard ignition. This grenade does not consume your currently equipped grenade, meaning you can use it and then use your base grenade after. Now guys, in order to get Gunpowder Gamble charges, you can simply get solar weapon or ability kills. Solar weapon kills give 1 charge, but scorch kills give 3. That means that this season only, Gunpowder Gamble is extremely easy to activate, since every Scorch weapon has Scorch rounds with Kindling Trigger and Flint Striker. If your Scorch rounds are active, all you need is 2 kills and you can spam Gunpowder Gambles non-stop. Now our third way of activating ignitions is through the artifact perk, Rays of Precision. With this artifact perk, Solar Precision Final Blows while you are radiant will cause ignitions. This just tops off this build so well, giving us a third method of ignitions. And just like that, we already have a very powerful gameplay loop of non-stop on-command ignitions. All you need to do is maintain your radiant buff by going for solar precision hits. This will give you free ignitions, but also scorch rounds, which you can then use as a precursor to a knife ignition. All of these solar kills will also be giving you gunpowder gamble charges. This is great, but we can take it even further by addressing a major issue: sustain. High output is fantastic, but in something like a Grandmaster Nightfall, if you cannot resist damage or heal, you will fall over. But guys, we can solve that very easily with very little commitment. All we have to do is slot on Healing Grenade, Ember of Solace, and Ember of Empyrean. And just like that, we gain infinite restoration. We don't even need to play differently. Just by throwing grenades at ourselves, we gain restoration, which is a powerful healing effect that persists even as we take additional damage. Ember of Solace makes this initial restoration effect from the grenade last longer, and then Ember of Empyrean will increase the duration of our restoration for additional solar kills. This is so critical since the entire point of this build is to frag out with ignitions and get solar kills to activate Gunpowder Gamble. In an enemy dense activity, we can keep our restoration up indefinitely. Now guys, for your other aspect, you'll want to grab Knock 'em Down. This will enhance your solar supers, but the main reason we're grabbing it is because of its secondary function, which refunds your melee charge for getting knife kills while radiant. When you pair this with the Ember of Torches fragment, it means that when we go for our knife ignitions, if the knife itself ends up killing a target, we will get our knife back for free to then go and get more ignitions. The final fragment I recommend is Ember of Singeing, which grants you 300% increased dodge energy while enemies are scorched. This means that with very little mobility investment, you will pretty much always have a dodge up to get your melee back. There are other great fragment options for this slot, and I wouldn't blame you if you wanted to use something like Ember of Eruptions here for the increased ignition damage and radius. One of the most important parts of any build is your exotic armor. For this build, at first glance, we have a few options, but in my eyes, there's only one real pick. For Solar Hunter, we are pretty much looking at Caliban's Hand, Shards of Galanor, and Celestial Nighthawk. Caliban's Hand does seem like it'd work, since it causes ignitions for proximity knife kills. The issue with Caliban's, though, is that it does require the melee kill to actually cause the ignition. Something like Weighted Throwing Knife is much more forgiving in higher end content, since you don't actually need a kill to activate the ignition. This allows the ignition to serve as both ad clear and single target damage, which is so important in high tier content. And while Shards of Galanor has recently been buffed, the same can be said for it. Shards of Galanor will now give you increased super energy for your knife kills, and this works fine, but it assumes that you are able to get knife kills. In my opinion, Celestial Nighthawk is your true choice. After the buff this season, Celestial Nighthawk now gives super energy for precision kills. Now, if you recall from earlier, this synergizes heavily with our build since we need solar precision hits to activate Radiant, and solar precision final blows also cause ignitions. In my eyes, this synergy makes Celestial Nighthawk a no-brainer. However, if you were really dead set on using Blade Barrage over Golden Gun, it wouldn't make the biggest difference in your output since your ignition spam and restoration sustain aren't tied to your exotic at all. In order to take maximum advantage of this build, you will want to synergize your weapons. One of the most important things we will need is to get those solar precision kills to activate Radiant, get ignitions, and get super energy. Something like Erianna's Vow does the job here excellently. Erianna's Vow one-taps many adds in endgame content and easily clears headshots. You may be inclined to try one of the many solar exotics like Promethium Lens or Jotun, but guys, at the end of the day, you're gonna want at least one of your weapons to be able to get those solar precision hits. Even a legendary solar scout rifle can do this job. Your second weapon should be focused on getting rapid solar kills in order to maintain our restoration and gunpowder gamble. Now, while we are in a rocket meta, machine guns will always be excellent for rapid ad clear. If you have a machine gun with incandescent, that will prove very useful here. At the end of the day, your weapon choices are up to you. Just be sure to be able to get those rapid solar precision hits and maintain your restoration with rapid solar kills. Now guys, this build is already so strong, but for some reason Bungie has absolutely juiced solar this season, and there's even more artifact perks. On top of all that we can already do, all of our solar abilities also cause weaken to champions with the Revitalizing Blast perk. This gives them a debuff, which causes our weapons to deal 15% more damage to them. Also, with the Heart of the Flame artifact perk, when we use our super, our allies gain increased super damage and they get Radiant. Nothing too crazy there, but it's definitely a nice touch. Guys, this build is absolutely disgusting, so be sure to copy everything on my screen, or you can use the dim link in the description. I had a ton of fun testing it, so give it a try today. If you enjoyed, be sure to subscribe, as I will be releasing a build for all three classes on Solar and Stasis this season. Either way, appreciate you watching, and I'll see you for the next video. Peace.